Marilyn is the Member of Parliament for Sarnia-Lambton and the Shadow Minister of Health for the Opposition, the Conservative Party of Canada. Delighted to have
great
you here. Thank you very much.
See you.
Yeah, we're thrilled to have your perspective on this too, because your role really puts you in the thick of these types of decisions as well, the policy decisions, the path forward, where we go from here. Two questions for you, but I'd like to start with the national opioid crisis, because we heard a little bit about it earlier during Susan's segment, and it's affecting not just the individuals who are in fact suffering from addiction, but entire communities. And it's also affecting not just the healthcare system, but first responders and others as well. How do you tackle this problem?
Well, I think it's important to make sure that you tackle it on several fronts. The first part is prevention. So preventing opioids from coming into the country, preventing over-prescribing, because most addiction facilities will tell you that the addicts that they have started either with prescription drugs or with marijuana. So starting on the prevention side, arming up the first responders to be protected, because you know there have been deaths and there are people that are frightened to intervene because a little speck of fentanyl can be deadly.
Right.
So prevention for sure, and then I think we have to get more treatment. There's inadequate treatment facilities across the country to get people off drugs, and that's really what the ultimate success is, preventing people from taking drugs in the first place and getting them off drugs. Right. And so I know that the government has been focusing on safe injection sites, but I really think in terms of prevention and treatment, more is needed.
Yeah. You had an incredible success with the private members bill, Bill C-277, which just recently became law.
Correct.
And it's with regards, the focus of the bill was palliative care and ensuring that Canadians had access to palliative care in their communities. It's clearly both a professional and a personal passion for you. But it's also a really major issue as we talk about MAID, medical assistance in dying. And as we talk about people's, we do have, as we discussed, have an aging population, and people want to have some element of control. Can you tell us about the bill and what you're hoping that Canadians will have access to?
Oh, sure. Today we have 1 in 6 are seniors in our country, and that'll be 1 in 4 in just a few short years. And so the bill is to get consistent access for palliative care for all Canadians. And 70% of Canadians today have nothing, no access to palliative care. And so, in their suffering situation and in light of the MAID legislation that came in, we need to do something. And the something that needs to be done will involve money. But the government and all parties supported the bill. And the government has pledged $9 billion so far. I think there was $3 billion in budget 2016 and $6 billion in budget 2017 for home and palliative care. Now, unfortunately, they've only spent $200 million of it. So I wrote a helpful letter to the Minister of Health, and I'm looking forward to working with her on where that $9 billion could go. But we certainly need more hospice infrastructure. We have less than 100 of them in Canada compared to 1,300 in the U.S. We are short of the service providers at all levels. We're missing at least 400 palliative care specialists. Many nurses and doctors receive no training in palliative care, and so training is another big piece of the puzzle. And then in rural and remote places, to try to figure out how to address bringing care there, there have been a number of really innovative solutions. In Nova Scotia, they started training their paramedics so that when they weren't responding to an emergency, they could administer, pain control palliative care. And that's a model that is both good for the patients who are having difficulty finding the transportation to get their treatment, and good from a cost outcome for the healthcare system, because there's a fixed number of dollars there, and as people start to need more money, palliative care in hospital costs about $1,100 a day versus hospice, $200 to $300, home care less than $200, and the paramedic model $90. So I think we have a chance to make our health dollars go further and get a better outcome for the patients.